It is Friday, January 9th. The markets in New York are open, and our big number this morning, 252,000. That is the number of jobs the U.S. economy added for the month of December, topping estimates and making 2014 the best year for jobs since 1999. Now, the unemployment rate also ticked down to 5.6%. There were a couple of worrying signs, though, from the report. Hello, everyone. I'm Dan Kleffler in New York. So here with the details on those numbers, Rick Newman from Yahoo Finance joining us on this Friday morning. So, Rick, the December jobs numbers are out there, beating estimates. Is it a good sign that employers are hiring more right now?
Sure. There really is no downside, at least in terms of the overall numbers, Dan. 252,000, that's a lot of jobs to add in 1 month. We ended up having a really good year for job creation in 2014, best since 1999, as you pointed out, likely to continue into 2015. Employers are finally doing what we wanted them to do back maybe in 2010 or 2011. This is the sort of robust rebound from a recession you'd like to see. It's coming a few years later than we like, but we're finally getting it.
Okay, so we've got more jobs added, but look at the jobs, what they're paying there. What about wage growth?
This is the big missing link in the recovery, and this tells you what's really changing about the economy over the longer term, Dan. So wages are up about 1.7% during the last year. They've gone up a little bit, down by a little bit, but that's basically where they've been. That's essentially the rate of inflation. So what that tells you is the typical worker is just not getting ahead when it comes to inflation. What you want to see is wage growth that's maybe a percentage point, maybe 2 percentage points ahead of inflation. That means people's living standards are actually improving. That's not happening yet. Now, what economists are telling us is just be patient. It is going to happen. First, you get the jobs coming back, and then as employers staff up, then later you get wage growth. We just are not seeing it. People are still struggling, even though jobs are coming back.
So where are those jobs coming back? Is there a particular sector?
Well, that's another good thing about what we saw in 2014. Jobs are coming back basically everywhere. There are still some big changes happening in the economy. For example, we're never going to see the number of good paying manufacturing jobs that we had, you know, in the late 90s or early 2000s. That's just a kind of a permanent change. We're going to, you know, technology is displacing workers. And we are definitely seeing people who probably lost a job a few years ago coming back into the labor force to a job that pays less. So this is a real struggle. This is going to be a long-term problem. You know, we're trying to find ways to deal with it, but this is not the easiest thing to turn around.
Well, so listen, I understand the unemployment rate is down now to 5.6%. What, though, is attributed to those that are just stopped simply looking for work?
Well, this is a puzzle. What we've seen is the percentage of people who are in the labor force, which means they're working age, they're not disabled. The people actually looking for a job has been going down, and that's a long-term trend. That is puzzling. What we have seen, we've seen an increase, a big increase, in the number of people, for example, who receive disability benefits. But you have to scratch your head and say, well, why would we have more people disabled these days? I mean, the workplace is actually safer than it was. We probably have had some households where there used to be two earners. Now they're getting by on one job. Maybe they've decided, we're just not worth it paying for childcare, or we're not earning that much to start with. I think there's no simple explanation for this, but this is a big change. We have not seen any turnaround here at all. We've seen fewer people who are of working age working, and that is probably a long-term trend we're going to have to adjust to.
And as far last, I want to ask you just about the wage growth on there, because that seems to be one of the things that a lot of people talk to, whether they're working on Wall Street or working on Main Street. What about raising the minimum wage then? What's the argument then for the pros and cons as far as, like, you know, the rising tide lifting all boats?
Well, you know, keep in mind, when you raise the minimum wage, you're just requiring employers to pay the lowest paid workers a little bit more. The thing about the minimum wage, it's never indexed for inflation, so it doesn't automatically go up with inflation, and really it should. That's what we do with Social Security payments, for instance. We don't have to have a battle every year in Congress over whether Social Security payments should go up. So we probably will see an increase in the minimum wage. It's not going to go up to $15 an hour the way some fast food workers want. It might go up to, if we're lucky, $8.50, $9 an hour. That'll help some people on the margin. That is not going to solve this larger problem of stagnant wage growth overall, especially in what you might call middle skill jobs, where people are earning more than minimum wage, but they may not be earning as much as they used to. That's a bigger problem that doesn't have a simple solution, Dan. So we're seeing some things going right in the economy, still some things we have to do.
All right, Rick Newman from Yahoo Finance on this Friday morning. Rick, thanks so much. Appreciate it. Have
sure
a good thing. Weekend. Of course, you can keep up with latest headlines right here on abcnews.com. You've been watching The Big Number. I'm Dan Kleffler.